Big data is not an individual concept that can stand on itself. It is a blend of old and new technologies. Big data is huge quantities of complex data that has been created over ages. And why complex data? Because some data is structured and stored in traditional relational databases, while a lot of it is unstructured. Hello learners, welcome back to Constant Learners. I hope you're all doing well and not stressing too much about studies, work, or just life. We've already discussed big data and a lot of concepts surrounding it in the past. Let's take a quick revision to finally understand what are the three main sources of big data. Let's start with the term big data. Big data is, we know that it is huge quantities of data, right? How huge? In 90s, even gigabyte was a lot of data, right? But today, a few terabytes or even petabytes is being generated, and this is known as big data. Can you believe that this much of data is being generated through multiple different sources? Why do we need so much of data? How is it generated? How is it stored or managed? What is the use of this data? These are some important questions that we need to look answers for, and we will slowly and steadily. But to be precise, this data assists organizations in acquiring significant knowledge. Right? And what is this knowledge used for? It is used to deal with enormous volumes of varying information, right? At the right speed. Why right speed? Because the data that was available yesterday is not exactly going to be useful today, right? Some of it may be, but a lot of it might not be even relevant today, right? At the perfect time, because the gadgets or the devices that were used yesterday might not be useful or relevant today. So perfect time, so that the companies or organizations can benefit from them. We also discussed the three V's of big data. Volume, that is how much data is being generated. Velocity, how fast that data is being processed. Variety, the various types of data, right? But big data could also be huge volumes of simple data or relatively smaller volumes of extremely complex unstructured data. So it's not necessary that data has to be in huge volumes and it has to be coming at a very high speed and it has to be in various formats, right? It could also be small quantities of very complex variable data, or it could be huge quantities of very simple data, all right? Also, this data needs to be accurate so that its analysis makes some sense. We also discussed three types of data, that is structured, unstructured, and semi-structured data. Structured data, of course, which can be stored in a particular format. Unstructured data, which is in multiple formats like text, video, numbers, images, statistics, all of it coming together, right? And this kind of data cannot be stored in a proper format. So that is unstructured data. And semi-structured data is a combination of both structured and unstructured data. I already have a video on my channel about this, and thank you so much for the amazing response that you all have shown on that video. Now, today, the data is being generated everywhere, right? From Google searches to WhatsApp messages to Instagram or Facebook posts, PDFs, emails, bank transactions, CCTV footages, Google Maps, Twitter, and so on. I don't think we can even name all of them. The data produced in olden times was also huge. Like a lot of data was being produced at that time also, but it wasn't stored and analyzed in a usable way, right? Mainly because the technology wasn't so advanced. But today the data is coming from all directions and steps are being taken to store, manage, and analyze this data correctly to make maximum use of it. Now let's head to the three main sources from which we get the big data, right? Where the big data is actually being generated. First is machine data, then social data, and the transactional data. Let's start with machine data. Machine data is automatically generated data. What automatically generated data? Like, this may include data from multiple sources, like sensors, like biometric or fingerprint sensors, all right? Then security logs or wearable medical devices. Then security devices, they could be CCTV cameras, proximity sensors, smoke detectors, mobile phones, computers, etc. All of these devices are generating data, all right? So these are known as machine data, okay? Now, all of these devices help the organizations to track employees as well as the consumer behavior, okay? And companies can use this data for their own benefit. They can identify the needs and demands as well as the future scope of a certain product while focusing on increasing the efficiency. Next is social data. Social data is, of course, from the word itself, we can understand the data that is generated through social media. All right. If we consider YouTube itself, videos, posts, likes, comments, where the video is being played, age, gender of the viewer, description, then playlist, all of this comes under social data. And just like YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, Twitter, etc., they are also generating so much of data, and they all come under the social data. All right. Now, there has always been advancement in these platforms. All right. There have been updates. We constantly get pop-ups, right? We need to update this app. All right. So these updates increase the potential in gathering more and more information from the user. All right. And this data plays a very crucial role in understanding the likes, dislikes, preferences, choices, views of customers on certain topics or events. Because we can openly write anything or display anything or portray anything or give our opinions about anything on social media, right? So the organizations or companies can easily identify what people are looking for or what people are accepting in their lives, right? And they can use this information to get qualitative as well as quantitative data, right? They can get a lot of data, right? So when the data is huge, of course, the management and processing will be difficult, but the authenticity of the data increases, all right? So it is also a fast way to communicate with a large audience. If your business is in India, you can easily spread the word across the globe through social media, because everyone around the world is on social media and anyone can view your profile, your products, your business and try to get something out of it. So it is also a very fast way to communicate with a larger audience and expand the geographic area of businesses. Thus, these days, social media branding has become a very important aspect in businesses, right? Where professionals are hired to manage the social media accounts. So that was all about social data. And third one is the transactional data. Now, from the name, we can say that transactional data is the information gathered through online and offline transactions while making purchases or maybe investments. Now, this includes so much of data like location, wherever, like we swipe a card. So when we swipe a card, we get so much of information from that. The location, like where the card was swiped, then time, what time it happened, date, amount, which product we have purchased, what discounts or coupons have we used. All of this data comes under transactional data. All right. Now, transactional data is the key source of business intelligence. All right. And can play a vital role in identifying the preferences of the customer in terms of products and services that he or she might be using. So we can identify what people are looking for. When we are buying something, maybe a product or a service, the businesses can identify what we are actually investing our money and time in, right? So it can be very useful for the businesses, all right? Thus, we can conclude that if we have proper technologies required to cater the problems related to big data, we can actually use it very wisely and solve loads of business problems, right? While not just benefiting ourselves, but also the world in general. That was all for this video. If you benefited from it, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and thank you so much for watching.